Welcome back to the channel. I'm Hank Strange. This is StrangerPalooza, and we are at SEMA Show 2023 in Las Vegas. We're actually here in the Overland Experience in the Winnebago booth with Noelle. And we are looking at the HIKE 100 series, basically a lightweight trailer, right?
Yep.
Guys might have already heard, Lola and myself are brand ambassadors for Sunshine State RV. And as Vanasaurs, I want to take this moment to encourage anyone who is in the market for a Class B van to start their journey with SSRV.
Sunshine State RVs specializes in selling Class B vans and B plus RVs. That is the reason why they are the number one dealer in all of the state of Florida.
Number three in the whole United States.
SSRV will fly you right to their location in Gainesville, Florida. They'll give you a very detailed and thorough walkthrough of your van, and they'll give you a two-night stay at a local campground so you can get used to your van. If you don't like that, you can actually have hands-free delivery anywhere in the United States of your RV.
We bought our Coachman Beyond from Sunshine State RV 2 years ago. And over the past 2 years, we've seen how they treat customers when it comes to warranty side. Their service team is great. Whether you bought it from them or not, every person that comes in there gets the same service and care when it comes to warranty repairs. The same service, attention, and care. And their team does a great job getting you back on the road safely.
So if you guys are in the market for a B or B plus van, consider Sunshine State RV. We've got a link in the description that you guys can use to see their current inventory and have someone get in touch with you.
Yep, lightweight overland trailer.
Okay, is this the lightest in Winnebago's lineup?
It is. This is gonna be the lightest weight and smallest trailer that we have, and then the most off-road capable.
Oh, also most off-road capable. That's why it's in the Overland Experience.
Yes.
How much does it weigh?
This one's 3,200 dry, and then you have about 800 pounds of carrying capacity.
Oh, okay. And what do you need to tow this with? Like, what's the smallest thing?
It's built for smaller trucks and SUVs, so it's a little too heavy for a Jeep or a Bronco. But you can use like a, I believe, 4Runners, a Tacoma, Jeep Gladiator.
Okay, like I have a Ford Transit all-wheel drive. That could probably, I think that could do about 5,000 pounds. So.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you could tow this behind it. Okay. Very cool. So just give me the spiel, Noelle. Give me the runaround this.
This is our HIKE 100 FLX. So we have the regular HIKE 100 and then the HIKE 100 with the FLX package.
Okay.
Basically all that means is this one can go off grid for up to 5 days. Mm-hmm. So it's gonna have a 320 amp hour lithium battery, 3000 watt inverter, Truma appliances.
Oh, cool.
200 watt solar panel. Like this week, we'll run it completely off the solar and the battery. Mm-hmm. We don't have to plug it in. Like I said, this is our most off-grid capable, most off-road capable. So it's gonna have Goodyear tires, independent suspension with Dexter torsion.
So is that adjustable or?
It is not adjustable.
It's not adjustable, okay. But very flexible, I'm guessing.
Yes.
Okay.
Yep, so I guess, not fully independent, but more independent than your traditional axle.
Okay.
And you get a lot more ground clearance with it, which is really nice. You get the power stabilization jacks.
Okay.
The construction of it, you have 2-inch thick sidewalls and then fully enclosed underbelly. So it's not 4 seasons capable, but extended season. This is our exoskeleton that we have patented. It's Thule and Yakima compatible, so you can plug and play with those accessories.
Okay, so anything that you can latch onto this, you could put up here.
Yep.
So so you could just strap things out here.
And on the roof.
And on the roof. So if you wanted to, can you put like one of those pop-out tents on there, or can't do that, right? Mm-hmm. Okay.
A lot of people ask that. I think it's just like a weight issue.
Okay.
Yeah. I believe it's 300 pounds per cross beam, but I think we just don't tell people that they
understood. Yeah. You take that on. if you overload it on the roof.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So up on the roof, you did say there were solar panels. Are those expandable? Can I like plug in anywhere here and put something outside?
So it's one 200 watt solar panel, and then it's prepped for additional panels, so you can just plug and play with a portable panel.
Okay.
If you wanted to install another one, you could do that as well up there. There's room. The roof is fully walkable, and you have a toy hauler style ladder on the side.
Okay, let's take a look at that. Yeah. Oh, I see. So I'm guessing this is a light that when you're connecting and everything, you put the light on here.
So you have the power tongue jack and power stabilization jack, so you don't have to crank anything, which is really nice.
Is this propane or something in here?
Yes.
Cool.
Yep.
Oh, here's the ladder.
Yeah, nice. So this is going to be the ladder, and this is where you would connect your other panel.
External panel. Cool, and then you can climb up there.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's going to be your cassette toilet.
Oh, okay. That's very similar to what you guys have in the vans, for example, Revel, etc. Okay.
And then you have an exterior shower. There's a batwing awning that hooks across here.
Forgive the loud audio. Obviously, at SEMA, everyone competes with who has the loudest audio. So you said there's a batwing option for this?
It comes standard on all of them.
Oh, it does? Oh, cool.
I just don't have it up here because of the space.
But
it would connect here and then along the back. And there's drop-down panels that magnet to the wall for your shower. So
you can build like a nice enclosure here. Okay, cool. And is this the standard FLX package that comes with this or graphics?
It is not. Normally,
it's not. Okay.
It's going to be your traditional white exterior. This one is just kind of like our overland edition, I would say. You can retail order with this wrap if you want.
Okay.
But we don't make them.
Okay.
Standard.
You don't. Oh, okay. All right. So, or you can get a standard and wrap it yourself if you want to. What is just a regular box?
So these are trash or whatever you want. Some Fender gearboxes that will come standard. You know, you can put your chocks or shower stuff or whatever you want while you're traveling. And there's one on the other side as well.
Okay. Is this the black tank here? Or what is this for here? It looks like you can connect some kind of hose to it.
Wouldn't have a black tank since you have the
cassette. Oh, of course, yes, right.
But that would be
gray. Gray, okay, cool.
And then this, so with the FLX, it comes, like I said, with all the Truma appliances.
Oh,
so this
AquaGo
is your water heater to get instant hot water throughout the entire trailer, which is huge for conserving water if you're trying to go off-grid for longer periods of time.
That's very cool. What batteries do you guys have in there? Is it, because I think some of your stuff is lithionics. Is that lithionics now?
So we have one 320 amp hour lithium lithionics battery in this one.
Oh, cool. All right.
And
I'm guessing that's expandable?
Yes.
Okay.
So you can purchase more batteries through us, and then we have a guide that helps you.
Right.
Install them.
And I think you guys have like a relationship with Lithionics. Ownership, actually.
Yes.
Okay,
recently.
Cool. What are we looking at here? Oh, this is your shore power?
Yeah. So this is where you would plug in. This one's 30 amp. And
then if you're getting internet goes there, is this to extend the awning?
So these are going to be your power stabilization jack.
Oh, for these. Oh, okay. Oh, cool.
And then this is just a brush guard. So if you're going down a smaller trail, you don't have to worry about anything.
So is this a little level I see here? Is that a little level for you to help figure out if you're level or not, or no?
Just a light.
Oh, that's just a light. Okay. So how do you do the leveling? Just put some levels in there, or?
Yeah, so when you, I mean, just like your traditional, you come out, you set up with your tongue jack, try to get it as level as you can, and then these are stabilizing jacks, so they won't level your unit, but just make it a little bit more stable.
So it's not bouncing.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is our SB model, so it's going to have the dual rear doors. You get a MOLLE panel and a flip down table to store more of your gear. And these are the windows.
Oh, cool. And you can open those. Nice.
Yes.
Put that one for you. Nice. Okay. Good to have ventilation. So you can have this open. Is there a screen or anything you could put here?
So this one has been on kind of a show circuit for the last year. But since that time, we now sell them with the rear screens.
Oh, okay.
If you purchase a model that doesn't have them, you can buy them through our parts department.
Okay, so you can put them on aftermarket.
Yeah.
Okay, very cool. So these kind of go together and make a bed here?
They do. So super easy.
Oh, look at that.
Flip it down. It's love reversible, it. So if you want the headboard on the side, you can do it either way.
Yeah, I like that.
And then they go
all the way up, kind of like a Murphy bed. Oh,
and then
sweet.
They would store so that if you wanted to put e-bikes or paddle boards in here, you have the tie-downs for it.
Oh, you got tie-downs. Nice. Okay. And we should probably go in that way and take a look at the amenities.
Yes.
This is a cool feature. I like this.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you can have like one person sleep here if you want to.
There's
well.
A bunch of different configurations you can do, which make it nice.
I'm right behind you. Let's go around this way and go in. Oh, we got a table.
Yeah. So this is going to be the flip down table. Just folds right up and comes back down. Then this is the other fender storage box. You have your LP connect right there, so you can put a grill and easily connect it.
Yeah. I like this along the side. I'm guessing this is like a brush guard kind of
well.
Thing.
Yeah.
Cool. Okay. And then I see we've got some of the connections over here, or at least, is that
so
a propane?
So that's the LP.
LP?
So
okay.
If you would plug in your grill, that's where you would.
And I do see a spare tire under there.
Yep. You're going to have a spare Goodyear tire.
Yeah. Cool. We'll get a better shot.
Yeah. Powered awning on this side with LED lights, so you get 200 feet of shade space when you have this out and the batwing awning, which is really nice.
Okay, cool. And so these, you've got to put the legs down, pin those down. Okay.
With this one, you don't. This one...
This has its own supports. Oh, cool.
Yeah, so it would just go
nice.
Out.
Okay, that's cool. Yeah.
The other one, the batwing awning, you would have to
set that up.
Yep.
Okay. Awesome. I'll follow you guys in.
So this is going to be your kind of kitchenette area and bathroom. You have, I believe it's an 5 cubic foot.
The fridge?
Yes.
Yes. This is standard.
Standard.
Like, yeah, I've got one of these in my van. Yeah.
Yep. You have a convection microwave.
Oh, nice.
Up here is just storage in here.
See, your control for
control
the Truma.
Panels. Yep, so this is going to control. You can check your tank levels, your lights, your awning.
Yeah.
That's going to be for all of your Truma appliances, so water heater, AC, and furnace. And this is for the GoPower solar panel and then the Xantrex inverter. All of those actually have apps that you can monitor. So if you're out and about and you want to check and see what's my battery at, you can do that just from your phone.
Yeah.
A little shelf space. You have a stainless steel sink in here. Residential style.
There's a lot in this. You've got a fan here, a vent fan, and you've got a Truma Aventa.
Yes.
That's awesome. Yeah.
And
this can run off the batteries, obviously, right? You don't have to be connected to shore power for this. Sweet.
So you can't run it, like, you couldn't run it 24/7. But if you came in, turn it on, let it cool down, and then turn it off and let your batteries kind of reboot.
I think with those batteries, you probably get a couple of hours.
Yeah.
Yes. If you expand, you can go like all night probably, going on and off.
Yes.
Depending
so
on
this one, with the FLX package, you can go off-grid for up to 5 days. Like you said, you would have to kind of go back and forth with your fridge and your AC, just figuring out what works for you dependent on how much power you use in other places.
Awesome. And there's a bathroom.
Wet bath.
And it's a full bathroom. It's got its own sink and everything in it.
So you're going to have your sink, your toilet paper holder, bath toilet. These come out, so they're just meant to be like gear drying racks. So you would take them out when you took a shower.
Yeah, that's cool. You can store stuff in here when you're traveling.
Yep.
Another vent in there. That's nice.
Skylight.
Yeah. Looks like you've got some good room in there.
Yeah.
You know, decent enough for the size of what we're doing here. And if you come this way, Lola, you've got another bed here. Oh, we're going to the closet. Yes, let's do the closet first.
So this is just your wardrobe, and they all come with an induction cooktop, so you can use that outside or inside. down here is just stored as well, but then your battery is stored under here. So your battery disconnect switch and everything is just right over there, so you don't have to take any panels off or anything to access that. And then, yes, there's the drop-down bed.
And that looks like it's on struts, so.
So it's super easy. You just pull your pins out.
Watch yourself, Lola.
And then, you start with this side.
Okay, you want me to pull this side down?
Nope.
Okay.
You'll just start over here.
Oh, I see.
And then it stays until you get over here.
Okay. Cool.
And then there you have it.
Yep. So you can sleep up to four in here.
Up to four, yes.
Yeah. That's really nice.
And I see you've got lights up there too.
Yeah, there's power up here, power plugs and
outlets.
Yeah, internet or, cable.
So this is for your Wi-Fi. It's prepped, so all you would have to do is purchase the Wi-Fi that you want and just plug and play. There's a backer right here for TV so that you can easily screw in your bracket. And
I'm actually surprised how much is in this trailer.
It's fully loaded for the size. Something that's huge is just the full height ceilings. A lot of smaller off-grid overlanding trailers don't have that, so being able to stand up even it's 6 foot five height, so you can really stand up, get dressed, just full access, which is really nice in your smaller trailers.
Absolutely. So the big question before we get out of here, what's the like average retail price of this? I know that stuff probably changes a little, but I'm sure folks will ask me.
Yeah, so with the Flex model, it's going to MSRP around $55.60. Right now, they're retail purchase only, so you would go to your dealer and purchase, and then we would fit it into production. With our regular Hike 100s, those are available on dealer lots right now. They MSRP around $35.40.
Okay, so with everything that comes with this, it goes up. And you go, you order it, and then you guys build it, right?
Okay. For the Flex ones right now. Okay. So the regular Hike 100s are available, but with the Flex package, you would want to contact your dealer and then put in an order, and we would go from there.
Okay, cool. So Floorpans, is it just this one, or are there others?
So we offer the Hike 100 in 5 Floorpans. This is going to be the maximum sleeping, up to 4. Some of them are going to have, you know, 2 twin beds. There's one with the dinette that turns into a bed. There's a few that have rear kitchens on the back. So both the Hike 100 and the Hike 100 Flex come with 5 different floor plans to choose from, but the size is gonna be the same on all of them. So they're all the 16 feet overall, but just the interior changes.
Noelle, thanks so much for giving
us that
run through. I appreciate it.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate you stopping by.
Yes. Now, for the folks out there who want to find out more about this, how do they do that?
So the best way is to go to our website, winnebago.com. We have a team of concierge. So if you click, I want more information, it'll send them an email and they'll get in contact with you. And you can find, you know, the closest dealer to you that would have the product. Download brochures, check out the specs, everything's online.
Awesome, thank you. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed that and the rest of our coverage from the 2023 SEMA Show in Las Vegas. Big thanks to Lola behind the camera. We'll see you guys on the next one. We're out. Peace.